why you're doing what you're doing and to get after it. Okay, you got 30 minutes to 40 minutes to go as hard as you can. And again, this is a lifestyle thing. When you're on your own after this camp, you wake up and you do these workouts on your own. Okay, I do these workouts all the time. Still to this day, wake up, 30 minutes, 40 minutes, go for it. Okay, the other day I was carrying my kid up the stairs, up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down in my house. Okay, because I needed my 30, 40 minute, I needed to go for it. Okay, I need to push. All right, so that's what you're looking to do. You're adding this to your lifestyle. Okay, one guy that did this crazy well is a guy named TJ Jolley. He was a guy that wrestled for my dad back when my dad was a coach. And this guy, he was a typical guy that just wanted to be a part of a team. And he was kind of a soft, pudgy guy. Matter of fact, he's kind of looked like a donut. He's really out of shape. He's super out of shape, and he never really understood what my dad had been preaching to all the kids on the team. And so he just wanted to be a part of the team. He just wanted to be on the team. And that guy struggled a lot. Matter of fact, he struggled so much he lost every single match as he was a freshman. Okay, and then the next year he went to camp and he started getting a little bit better, and he was kind of like, man, maybe I should kind of figure this thing out. But he still didn't put the work in, and going into sophomore year, he loses every single match. Heavyweight just gets pinned, 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 pinned. And one day he finishes camp and he remembers all the messages, something starting to click in his head. And matter of fact, this guy, he also had about five sisters, and he had a couple brothers, he had a big, huge family. And those sisters would beat him up. And he was out of shape, and they'd beat him up, they'd make fun of him, and he finally had it. He was sick of it. So he took off, and he ran down the road about 4 miles, and he knocks on our door. And our door, I was a young kid, my dad was the coach of the school, my mom answers the door. My mom answers the door, and there's TJ. He's in the front of the door, and he's crying. He can't even breathe. He can't hardly talk to my mom. He's crying. Tears are running down his face. And my mom's like, look, what are you doing? Just calm down. Just calm down. It's all right. What's going on? Just calm down. He's nervous. He's having anxiety. Okay. And he's crying. He's scared. And he's going to talk to my dad. And my mom goes, hey, one sec. I'm going to go get Scott. He'll help you out. Okay. So my dad comes up. And my dad goes, oh, my gosh, TJ, what's going on? You know, what's the matter? And he goes, coach. And he's kind of crying. He's choked up. And he said what you all said on the first day of camp. He said, he couldn't get it out. I want to be a state champ. And my dad kind of at first was kind of like, okay, buddy, yeah, okay. Yeah, well, I could say that, you know. But at that program, like if you said that, that was dangerous because you knew what that was going to entail because of how he coached and how he trained his wrestlers. So all those kids were, you know, like, I mean, if you said that, that means you better be putting in the work. So at first, my dad kind of ignored it. But then he realized, you know, he's the coach, and he kind of thought again, and he said, you know what, he kind of turned around, he kind of swallowed his throat, and all of a sudden he comes back at the kid, and instead of being a nice little coach and supportive, he barked at that kid. And a little vein starts to pop out of my dad's head when he gets pissed. And he goes, you know what you just said? You know what you just asked? And he gets up in his face, and he's kind of like, dang it, TJ, like you don't come to my house and just say that. After you've been not wrestling hard when I ask you to wrestle hard, you don't show up to every single workout, you lose every single match, your effort's not there, you don't care, you get pinned. I don't even know how you have the guts to even say that. I want to be a state champ, right? That is crazy to him that he said that. He said, you know what? And he grabs him and he brings him down the driveway and he shoves him in the truck. My dad had a flatbed truck, one little bench seat. He shoves TJ in the truck. Get in the truck. Starts the car, kicks up the dust, heads out the driveway, speeds up to the high school, and he shoves him into the high school wrestling room. He says, put your shoes on, let's go. You want to be a state champ? I'll show you what it takes to be a state champ. He was not going to take it easy on him because he was going to make sure that day he understood it was a different level. It was not being a part of something. It was about to immerse yourself with effort and hard work, discipline, and just continually do that. So he puts him in the wrestling room, and he's in there, he's wrestling him, and double leg, boom, takes him down, double leg, boom, takes him down. He starts to get tired, he starts to break, he's crying, boom, double leg, takes him, boom, wrestling him, come on, TJ, get up, come on, TJ, he's wrestling him, boom, takes him down, come on, TJ, hard hands, he is not being easy on him. Matter of fact, one time he goes, double leg, he takes him down, and back in the day, we had a weight room right next to the wrestling room, and it was together. He slides off the mat, TJ hits his head on a plate. Cuts his head open, huge cut, blood coming down everywhere. TJ's crying. He's like, coach, okay, I gotta go fix this. And he's trying to walk away. My dad's like, what are you doing? He's like, get back in here. That's not what it's gonna take. You can't escape the room. You can't get out of this. Grabs the tape, takes his head, shoves him back in, boom, double leg, boom, double leg, boom, double leg. He is wrestling him hard. Finishes practice like 2 a.m. The parents don't know where their kid is. He ran away that night looking for my dad to say he wanted to be a state champ. My dad grabbed him and took him to the room to show him what it meant to be a state champ. 2 a.m, his parents are looking for him, they call the cops, They don't know where he's at. They're out looking for him. The cops call my dad. Tell my dad, because we're a pretty close, tight community. My dad's like, oh, don't worry, I got him. Put him in the car, drive him back to his house, drop him off. He doesn't say a single word to him. My dad doesn't say a single word to him. Put him in the car, drop him off, back at his house. Parents are all worried. TJ goes into his bedroom, goes to sleep. The next morning, TJ wakes up, puts his backpack on, and runs to school. The next morning, he wakes up, puts his backpack on, runs to school. Next morning, boom, 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 boom. TJ then starts showing up to everything. Every single morning workout, every single practice, every single wrestling camp, and he starts to win. He gets 5 or 6 matches in his junior year. And he's like, okay, I'm starting to get this. He really puts more time in than anybody else is putting in. And this little pudgy little TJ starts turning into an absolute beast. Okay? He is huge. I mean, huge. From the time he was a freshman, he starts growing, growing, growing. But this time he's been putting in the work. And he is huge. He's quick. He's fast. He's explosive. Okay? And he goes into his senior year, and he's starting to win, guys. He's starting to win. He's starting to win. And he pins. And he pins. And he pins. And he pins, and he keeps pinning, and he's undefeated going into the district tournament. And going into that tournament, he's getting ready to wrestle this guy in purple singlet from Connell High School, and he's getting ready to wrestle this guy, and he's kind of the team leader now of this team. Pretty amazing. And he's getting ready to wrestle this guy, and this guy starts to beat him, takes him down, starts to beat him, and he dominates him. He dominates TJ, and TJ breaks like he broke that one day. He breaks. And my dad was so frustrated because this kid had made it so far. Just a break, just a crack when it counted. When he had an opportunity to get it done and grab the medal and rip it away, he cracked. So my dad got right back on him, got in his face, right back on him. Right back on him, telling him what type of work he's put in, why he's done it, why would you just, you know, throw it all away for one, you know, just easy workout. So he grabs him, you know, he's kind of on him, and right back to work TJ goes. He's back in the room, he's working hard, he's working with the coaches, he's working with the kids, he's running to work, running to school every single day. TJ Jolley goes to the state tournament, starts winning, boom, boom, boom. Takes 4 matches, right? 4 matches to win the state tournament in Washington, right? 4 matches, okay? Wins the first one, wins the second one, wins the third one. He gets to the finals, and guess who he's wrestling? Kid from Connell, kid in the purple singlet. He's wrestling him. He's getting ready to wrestle, and this time my dad's a little nervous because he knows that TJ has what it takes to wrestle this kid, but this kid literally majored him in the district finals, like dominated him. And so he's getting ready to warm up, and he's bouncing like this. My dad's in his suit. He's all dressed up for the state finals. And, you know, some coaches do that. They get all dressed up for the state finals. It's a special moment. And TJ's over there warming up, all big, huge. TJ's warming up like this. He's bouncing in spot. And my dad comes up behind him, and TJ's looking straight at his opponent. He's looking directly at him, and he's bouncing. And he's whispering. He's whispering to himself. He's looking at that guy, and he's saying, you haven't done what I've done. You haven't went to camp every summer. You haven't worked out with coaches every day. You didn't run to school every day. He's going like this. And he's like, I'm gonna dominate you. I'm gonna beat you. I'm gonna beat you. I'm gonna get you. And he's just talking to this kid straight at him, but he's whispering it. My dad didn't know. You know, he's kind of nervous about the match, but he sneaks up behind TJ just to give him a little pat on the back, you know, kind of warm him up for the state finals, and he hears him whispering. And the chills in my dad's arms just kind of stand up. And my dad just gets pumped up, like, yeah, my boy's ready. My boy's ready. He's ready. He's got it. He understands. He's getting it. This is his match. And out he goes against that same kid. Take down. Okay. Take down. He's beating this kid all of a sudden. This kid starts to crack. And at our school, when a kid would start to break, my dad would say, hey, he's ready. He's ready. He's broke. He's broke. So that meant you needed to finish him. You needed to pin him. Okay. You needed to put the match away. So the kid takes a shot. He just stuffs him like this. Pulls him over to his back. Puts him on his back. 1, 2, 3. Boom! Pin in the state finals. TJ jumps up, hands in the air, tears in his eyes, okay? Super excited, runs over to my dad, jumps up into my dad's arms. This little pudgy little TJ figured it out. He made a choice. One day he said, I want to be a state champ. My dad started in the process of showing him what that was going to take. And he made a choice one day, and the next day, and every single workout, from that point on, he made a choice, okay, to chase it the right way. I share that story with you guys because you have a choice right now. Right now you have a choice to chase it the right way for 30 minutes. That's it, 40 minutes, that's it. So I want to challenge you guys, chase it the right way today. All right? All right, here we go. Where are my groups?